नमस्कार, आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस एपिसोड ऑफ अनटोल्ड माफियाज। टुडे आई डिस्क्राइब टू यू वन ऑफ द ओल्ड हेरिटेजेस ऑफ द सिटी ऑफ कोलकाता। लाइक एनी अदर थिंग इन दिस प्लैनेट, द सिटी ऑफ कोलकाता इज ऑल्सो चेंजिंग डे बाई डे। द फेस ऑफ द नोन सिटी इज चेंजिंग अलॉन्ग विद द सेंचुरी। आई डोंट थिंक एनी वन कैन फाइंड द ओल्ड कोलकाता। Well, by using the word old, I didn't mean Kolkata of the British period. Take the example of Kolkata in the 1980s. I'm sure no one will be able to find her too. Well, it's quite normal. So many things are happening around you. High rises, mall, food court, multiplex, and on and on. There is another Kolkata amidst this Kolkata despite of all these changes. Here the time rests unvarying. The Indian coffee house is one of those. Come, let's walk inside the coffee house. If you are coming from the direction of the Calcutta University, the Hare School will be on your left. Then the Presidency University. Turn right by keeping the Presidency University on your left and it's Bunkim Chatterjee Street. Your well-acquainted area, the famous book belt. Now, while looking around, you will notice an old three-storied building. There are rows of book stalls on the road. There you will notice a small door. On the top of the door there is a signboard, the Indian Coffee House. You will find the stairs to go up in the light and shade. There is a cigarette stall too, just beside the first step. Let's climb up the stairs and take left and step in the first floor, the right door, and finally you have reached the heart center of culture and gossips of Kolkata, the Indian Coffee House. Look at the two big windows on your right. If you look down from there, you will have a clear view of the entire book belt and can hear the cacophony of the book belt. Look ahead. See, there is a big hall, varieties of pictures hanging there. That high counter in front of you is the cash counter of the coffee house. There are lots of square-shaped tables with four chairs around in the room. Recently, a few fiber chairs are found there. Well, that much change is normal. The ceiling is too high. Look at the top. The old-fashioned fans are hanging with long iron rods. These fans are scarce nowadays. The waiters are in white uniform and turban. There is a long balcony on the left upstairs, and if you sit there, you will get a bird's eye view of the total coffee house area. In spite of the presence of so many ultra new amusement places of modern Kolkata, the 1880s rush to this vintage coffee house every single day. The only reason is that this is a pure chatting place. This coffee house was first initiated in Kolkata in the year 1876 at Albert Hall. Can you imagine about it? 1876, when Swami Vivekananda was only 13 years old, Gandhiji was a mere kid of 7 at that time, and Netaji was born after about 21 years. The concept of coffee house started from 1936. This was a chain restaurant. It had several outlets. The first outlet was in Bombay. India was under British rule. Independence movement had started, and at that point of time, Indians were not allowed in the coffee house. It was written on the board that dogs and Indians are not allowed. Then, Indian Coffee House was planned. In the year 1947, central government renamed the Albert Hall as Indian Coffee House. Once, the Indian Coffee House was about to close down. Do you know what a few of the coffee house lovers did at that time? They bought all the unsold cutlets at night. In the year 1953, the impaired coffee house was closed down. A few professors of Calcutta University and Presidency College initiated to make it run again. The Chief Minister of Bengal, Dr. Bidhan Rai, and the eminent educationist, Professor Nirmal Chandra Chando, took active part in this action. That time, Coffee House was closed for 28 days. This year, it was closed for 103 days due to the corona pandemic. You all have become much impatient, it seems, and I know what you are all thinking. What's this? There's no mention of that famous song by Manna Day. Forgot it or what? Relax, friends. How is it possible to talk about Coffee House without this? In fact, I know that this song is well known to you all. So I decided to tell you the story behind the making of the song, rather than to mention it. I'm sure you will appreciate it. In those days, Gauri Prasanna Majumdar and Nachiketa Ghosh were a famous pair. Gauri Prasanna was the lyricist and Nachiketa was the composer. They were good friends. One day Gauri Prasanna went to Nachiketa's house. Nachiketa's son Suparnakanti was much late in returning home. Gauri Prasanna teased him. "Ah, I see. So you are spending the time with fun outside." Suparnakanti promptly replied to his Gauri uncle, "You always write love songs. Why don't you ever write Onadda? Come, start with the chatting session of the coffee house." By that time, Gauri Prasanna had composed the first two lines. He said, "Take it down. The chat session of the coffee house is no more." That time, Gauri Prasanna was suffering from cancer. On his way to Madras for treatment, he wrote the rest of the lines of the song on a packet of cigarettes sitting at the station. The song sung by Manna Day, music by Suparnakanti, has become a milestone. Yes, one more thing to tell you, that all the characters of this song existed. None is a fictitious character. Now, what's the charm of this coffee house? Gossiping, chatting. It's nothing but a chat room. Who didn't step in there? Rabindranath Tagore, Subhash Chandra, everyone. The famous Kollol era was developed here. Hrithik Ghatak, Shakti Chattopadhyay, Sunil Gangopadhyay, all assembled here. With a cup of coffee and with cigarette smoke rolling around the room, they all continued their chatting, arguments, discussion, poetry. Even sometimes they were about to fight. What were the topics of such tremendous discussion and argument? Everything and anything under the sun. Truly, these gossips, argument, everything are the medium of thought exchange. That time, Coffee House was the heart center of the Renaissance of Bengal. It was the meeting place of the hungry generation leaders. Women's lib also flourished here. Once I came to know from one of the staff of College Street Coffee House that whoever joins here is to join as a washerboy first. After working here for a few years, he becomes eligible to choose his department. The salary is the same for all. Everyone is to do every job. The tip collected is kept together and then it's distributed equally among all the staff. Those days, a cup of coffee costed 50 paisa. Some people didn't even have that money too. It was no major issue. They distributed that single cup of coffee among three easily and carried on their chatting. Some people even used to come and sit, then have a glass of water and went away. That time, it was a custom to serve two glasses of water. No one ever took it otherwise. Oh my God, I'm talking on Coffee House since then, but till there is no mention of the menu. The signature items are black coffee, onion pakoras, kobiraji cutlet, sandwich, and the famous fusion coffee. Moglai porota, Afghan porota are also famous. These days, they are preparing new trendy delicacies, but the traditional menu is still very much there. Even today, Omols come here with a dream to become the sunshine. D'Souza's come to relax after day's hard work. Roma Roy's still shed tears silently. No one notices. No one today has that time for anyone. Rama Roy, D'Souza, Amol are no more. But the old coffee house still longs for them. Like and share our video and comment on it. Also, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to get the latest updates.